Chilling and blessed.
Jaden, talking with the commanders, I know that they're planning on talking with you later on. They're interviewing you. I imagine you're interviewing them as well. What do you want them to know about you?
This is something they got to do their homework, but I'll say for both, it's like, who's going to invest in me? Who's going to believe in me? Kind of like LSU did on and off the field, as a man and a player. So I'll say that's kind of the biggest thing, but they probably already did their homework. They know who I am as a person and who I am as a player.
Jaden, same question regarding the Patriots. And I know there was some conflicting reports as to when you were supposed to meet with the Patriots, whether it was last night or today.
It's today.
And it's the same sort of vibe.
When yeah,
it
comes same to- vibe. Same vibe for everybody. Who's going to invest me, and believe in me as a man, as a quarterback, on and off the field.
Hey, Jaden, Brett Martell with AP. So how do you feel about your prospects for going? I mean, you're getting a real sense that you're going to go in one of those top few spots, and how ready do you think you are going to be right away to play in the NFL?
God wouldn't put me in nothing that he didn't feel I could handle, so obviously he put me in this position. My life is calling mapped out, only he knows. So it's just going out there. I feel like I'll be ready. It's a learning curve for everything. I'm just ready, hear my name called and then go in there just ready to learn and, meet my new teammates.
Another one about a specific team for you. With Washington, has anything specific stood out about them, and how would you feel if you did go there?
I mean, it would be a blessing wherever I go, just hear my name call. With them, it's a new regime there. Cliff Kingsbury is at Arizona, what he done in his track record with quarterbacks. Dan Quinn, a good head coach, obviously when he was with the Falcons as a head coach, obviously led them to the Super Bowl. So it's just good to see the new regime and see what plan they have in place, for whoever they take, one of the quarterbacks and, moving forward.
Over here, Jaden. Tony Thomas, Mike Farrell Sports. What do you attribute your development and growth as a quarterback from your first season here to your Heisman Trophy winning season last year?
That was kind of just like my first true off season. Every off season I was kind of dealing with something. Wasn't injury wise, but obviously learning a new playbook my freshman year, and then you deal with the pandemic, and then I'm dealing with personal stuff off the field. So it's kind of my first true offseason. It makes it easier when I'm able to build that camaraderie, that chemistry with my receivers. And obviously, we see it. Y'all seeing it today. It's still there. Those are my brothers for life. So it makes it easier throwing the ball to them too.
Jaden, with the routes and throws that you guys selected today, it seemed like going under center wasn't something y'all did a whole lot of here at LSU last year. What were you trying to show, and how do you think you did with them?
Yeah, I'll just say the main thing was to try to show my consistency within the pocket and my footwork, moving off platform, in rhythm, progressions coming back to a third read, just move around and make sure I get my feet back under me. And the other stuff was kind of just fun, it's just something that we do. We out there having fun, you hear the music playing, you're out there having fun, the deep ball, that's kind of the show. Show that my guys they got the speed, they could track the football. I could go out there and put it out there for them.
Yeah, Jaden, right here. Last year, this time, you really wasn't on anybody's draft radar. What did you feel like you had to do this past season to jump to where you are now?
What I did this past season? Just go out there and just prove myself. Obviously, I had to put myself back on the market, but it's day in, day out. This is a goal I set. That's a goal that me, Malik, and Brian set. This is how we want our life to map out. We know you just put in the work and you go out there and you got to execute it.
Jaden, at the combine, you said you weren't going to participate until pro day. That way you can shine the light on your teammates that didn't get an invite to the combine. And all day you've been cheering them on and being there for them. Just how much it meant to you to do that for them, and also wearing Greg Brooks on your shirt. How much did that mean?
It meant a lot. That's, obviously, if Greg was here, he'd be a part of this. So he's not here, but, he's here in spirit. I'm here to rep him. You know, my teammates that didn't get an invite to the combine, obviously they had multiple eyes out here, all 32 and more. So it was great for them to go out there and showcase the talent, showcase how they move, and, you know, write their own journey. You know, they get an opportunity, you know, I know they're going to crush it.
Yeah, hey, Jaden, you obviously leave here and you hand the keys over to a guy like Garrett and Ricky, who's also in that room. You know, you spend a lot of time with those guys the last couple of years. Just what do you think about the future of the quarterback room at LSU?
I think it's in good hands. You know, whether that's Ricky or whether that's Nuss, it's in good hands. And, you know, go out there, they're their own person. So I'm excited to see them grow into that role and then, you know, see what they could do, you know, this upcoming season.
Jaden over here. I think you responded on Twitter. Somebody had reported that you wouldn't want to play for the Patriots. And I'm just curious, you know, what it would be for you to get drafted by the Patriots and if you would like to go up there and play in New England.
Man, same as for everybody. You know, it's whoever want to draft me, whoever believe in me. The stuff that I can't control who, you know, calls my phone on draft day. So, you know, it is what it is. But you know, just the reports out there, you know, obviously sometimes you got to call out cap for people. So, you know, that's what I had to do.
Coach Kelly was talking about how he keeps hearing the question about you and at the next level, can he slide or will he slide? How much of that have you been working on and how much of that is a skill that, you know, some quarterbacks kind of, you know, have to learn how to pick up on?
I mean, towards the end of the year, I was sliding more. Well, not really sliding, but, you know, being smarter. But, you know, it just comes with longevity. You know, just know when the journey is over, when I was getting out of bounds, you know, getting down. So, early in the season, you know, I was kind of, you know, trying to make a little plays. You know, I thought I was kind of faster and stuff. You know, there's a lot of other things that go into it, stuff that we argue about outside of this building. But, you know, it's remotely on me at the end of the day.
Thank you, Jay.
Appreciate y'all.
Thank y'all.